Hey friends, I'm Tasia, and this video will highlight the 10 best Chrome extensions for students. So my picks for best Chrome extensions for students range from productivity tools to grammar tools to citation generators and even money-saving extensions. So I've done my best to group these in the corresponding categories. Let's go! If you're a student, you know time management and productivity are super important. So much of this video will focus on free productivity extensions. In fact, all of the extensions are free. So with that said, let's start with some of the best Chrome extensions for productivity. And first up is Bitly, my go-to link shortener. Now this is going to be a handy extension for you if you need to create shortened links for aesthetic purposes or if you need to create custom URLs for a project. Now I recommend creating a free Bitly account before you start shortening links. Then from any page that you want to link, just hit the Bitly extension. A pop-up on the right-hand side will appear with a shortened link that you can copy and share. It'll tell you the title of the web page, and then underneath that, you can customize the link. Something else that's super useful with Bitly is the ability to track click-through rates via your Bitly account. Up next in the productivity category is Boomerang for Gmail. Now I've talked about Boomerang before, but this is an extension that is not to be missed. So I use Boomerang within my Gmail account itself, but if you're scrolling the web and come across something you want to send in an email or even schedule in an email, you can do that with just the extension. You don't have to copy a link and go back to your Gmail at all. So from the web page, click on the Boomerang extension. And you'll notice a new Gmail tab opens with this new compose window here, and it automatically has the link in there already. You can add whatever other details you want, and then either send it now or send it later. And of course you have the option to boomerang it back to you if you don't get a reply. And then once you're done, the tab automatically closes for you. Okay, this next pick is another one I've been using for quite a few years. It's Colorpick Eyedropper. This is a great extension if you want to take that extra little bit of customization to a project. So how many times have you been scrolling a website and you wonder, what color is that? Or, gee, I'd really love to match that color to a project I'm working on. Well, simply select the Colorpick Eyedropper extension and your mouse will turn into, well, a color picker. So simply move your mouse over the color you want to match and then left click once you've hovered over the color. You're instantly given the color hex code and then you can copy and paste that over to your color board of the project you're working on. It's really that simple. All right, this next extension made my list for best Chrome extensions for Google Meet, which is a video I'll link to in the description below if you want to check that out. The extension is called Dualless, and it essentially creates a split screen or a dual monitor if you don't have a second screen. So here's how it works. All you have to do is click the Dualless extension and then select your preferred screen dimensions here. And blammo, your screen is now a split screen. And you can adjust the ratios here too by dragging on a window and resizing it. Okay, this next extension I'm including in the productivity category because you can think of it as a good kickstart to your day, and that's Momentum. Momentum is a way to enhance your Chrome tab. So rather than seeing this normal new tab page from Chrome that is uninspiring to say the least, Momentum offers an alternative option. It's a replacement of that boring new Chrome tab. Momentum displays a new background image and quote every single day to keep you inspired. Plus, you can add to-do lists on this tab too and your reminders for the day, as well as a snapshot of the weather. All right, rounding out my productivity extensions is Pocket. Now I've mentioned Pocket before and for good reason. It's a massive time saver. Now just like with some of the other extensions, I recommend you create a free Pocket account first and I recommend you download the companion apps for Pocket. So if you're scrolling the web and come across an article, or say someone sends you an article, but you don't have time to read it right away, simply save it to Pocket for later. So when you come across that article that you are going to use, say for a project, just select the Pocket extension and the link automatically saves to your Pocket account where you can read it at your leisure. All right, let's move on to my picks for the best Chrome extensions for grammar and language tools. And first up in this category is Google Dictionary. And this is created directly from Google, so it works in a snap. The first thing I recommend doing is to click on the extension and select the extension options. And then from here, toggle on your preferred settings. And I like to toggle on this option to keep word history. So now, if you're reading an article and you come across a word you don't know, simply double click it and a pop-up with a definition appears. How neat is that? Next up is another great tool for grammar and spelling, and that's Grammarly. And this is another one where I recommend you set up a free account prior to diving into the extension. Now, the Grammarly extension can help you with spelling and grammar, as I said, but it also helps you with clear communication of your ideas. It looks out for things like tone and delivery in your writing, as well as helping you to determine if you're plagiarizing work without even knowing it. So it's kind of like having someone proofread your work for you, but in real time. The Grammarly extension works in any tab that you're writing in. So think when you're composing an email or typing out a school project, etc. As you type, it'll give you suggestions and corrections, as well as some word definitions too. Plus, Grammarly is now beta testing in Google Docs. Heck yeah! All right, my last two picks for best Chrome extensions for students actually fall under their own categories, but they're just as useful. So first up, let's start with a citation generator extension, MyBib. That's right, this is an extension that generates citations for you in all kinds of different styles. My God, if I had this when I was in school. Game changer. So if you're citing an article for your paper, just click on the MyBib extension and then select your style. So MyBib has MLA, APA, AMA, and more. Sweet heavens, yes. So once you select the style you need, voila, your citation is formatted for you, just like that. Are you kidding me? Now, MyBib even tells you if the source is credible or not. You can then click on the citation itself to copy it, or you can save it to a project right from here. And that'll open up your MyBib projects tab. So I do recommend creating an account if you want to keep everything extra organized. Is that not the coolest extension ever? But I do have one more as promised, and that's the Honey extension. And this is my go-to extension for savings and coupon generation. So here's how it works. Honey is an extension that finds and applies coupon codes for your online shopping. So if you're a student, you need to save where you can. And Honey does the work for you. It automatically searches for and applies discount codes or coupons when you're shopping online. So as soon as you head to your shopping cart, Honey will pop up and with just one click, it runs through hundreds of possible discount codes for you. If it finds one, it'll reflect it in your price. Or if it doesn't find one, it'll tell you if you have the best price available. Gone are the days of searching for individual codes before you check out. Massive time saver. Thank you, Honey. So those are my picks for the 10 best Chrome extensions for students. What are some of your favorite productivity extensions? Let everybody know in the comments below. As always, thank you guys so much for watching. If you like this video, I want to know. So give it a like, a share, or leave that comment below. You can click right about here to subscribe to my channel and up here for another video. Thanks for watching, guys. See you next time.